Good evening to wherever you may be. It's time now for Midnight Baseball's 2018. Before spring training gets started, we're reviewing every team, the current roster, what you need to know, and how can they fare well in the 2018 season and hopefully make it to the World Series. Last time we did the New York Yankees, today we're doing the Red Sox, right? The rivals. But what's new in baseball as of today, February 5th, 2018? Todd Frazier signed a 2-year deal with the New York Mets. Yes, the Todd father is staying close to home, to New Jersey, signed with the Mets. Should be a fun little fill-in for 2 years there for the Mets and Frazier. Love to see him get paid. Frazier's a good friend of mine as far as baseball players go, and always cheering for him. So Todd father, good job. Topic two, collusion and stalemate on the free agent market between the agents, the teams, and now the unions getting involved. But it's pretty simple, right? First year of a new collective bargaining agreement equals a luxury tax threshold of $197 million, which equals a soft salary cap. So in essence, when you're paying 100% penalty in tax, when you go over the threshold of 197, no big market teams want to go over it anymore, okay? So a soft salary cap has been created. As much as Tony Clark doesn't want to admit it, the last deal the CBA got might have been in favor of the owners. So let's just get baseball going forward. Let's not talk about boycotts of spring training or anything else. Let's just move ahead and forward, play baseball. The game is great. It's prospering. The players might not be getting paid as much money as they want this offseason, but there's a lot of different factors. The number one being the new soft salary cap. If you want to know more about that, hit me up on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, however you want to talk. Let's go. Okay, the Boston Red Sox, as we know, won the American League East last year. They went to the playoffs in the first round, lost to the Houston Astros, who went on to win the World Series. So what did they go out and do? They hired their bench coach as a manager, right? Alex Cora. I always say Joey and Alex, but Alex Cora, the former manager of the Puerto Rican national team, was a bench coach of the World Series champion Astros, is now one of the new young managers in baseball, had the helm for the Boston Red Sox. Can he bring his new philosophy of a player manager, using analytics, using his player experience, right? I didn't mention Aaron Boone and the Yankees last time, but Aaron Boone, Alex Cora, a bunch of new managers going on in what's considered the biggest rivalry in baseball, but we all know it's Dodgers and Giants, right? But hey, in left field, Andrew Benintendi, center field, JBJ, Jackie Bradley Jr. in right field, one of my favorite players in all of baseball, Mr. Mookie Betts. Starting at third base is the second-year player, Rafael Devers, shortstop, phenomenal young player, Xander Bogaerts. Second base is manned by Dustin Pedroia, but just having back surgery, Pedroia is going to be out for about a couple months, 2 or 3 months for the majority of the first half. Brock Holt will fill in at second base. First base is going to be manned by Mitch Moreland, who came back on a 1-year deal this year with Boston. And also Hanley Ramirez is DH/first base. Behind home plate, Christian Vasquez is the catcher, along with Sandy Leon and Blake Swihart, the former prospect. So I love the Boston lineup. I think Boston's going to win the American League East again. Okay, why? Because they got Chris Sale. Chris Sale is leading the staff. David Price, Rick Porcello, Drew Pomerantz. And then bringing up the rear of the fifth starter is Stephen Wright, the knuckleballer. Can he come back healthy this year? I hope so. It was fun watching the knuckleball dance 2 years ago. So, but the bullpen is a little bit concerned for me. We've got Craig Kimbrell, Carson Smith coming off of injury, Joe Kelly, all throw gas, and more gas. But there's missing a left-hander in the bullpen. Go out there, maybe make a trade at some point, or find a way to get a left-hander involved in the bullpen. And I really like what Boston is doing, okay? So here's the questions. Red Sox win the East this year. After coming up winning it last year, I know the hype's in the Yankees, but I like what Boston is doing. Their core is solid, especially with the outfield, right? Call them the Triple Bs, just amazing. I mean, Benintendi, Betts, Bradley. Bradley Jr.'s bat's coming around. His defense is spectacular. Benintendi will be an all-star this year. Watch him be a first-half breakout. And Mookie Betts is just the man, right? What can you say about Mookie? He does a five-tool player. Fun watching him bat, okay? Three big questions are, you hear about J.D. Martinez. Should Dave Dombrowski and the ownership of the Red Sox give J.D. Martinez the big deal he wants? It started off at $200 million. Apparently, it's come down to $125. Somewhere in the middle there, for 5 years, $140, J.D. Martinez will sign. But if I'm the Red Sox, pass. Why do I want to sign all this money for a guy who's known to be a defensive liability and strictly a DH? Because if you bring him on as a DH, guess what? Where does Hanley Ramirez go? We already know Hanley has a big deal. Pablo Sandoval got a big deal. David Price did a big deal. Boston in the last few years is known for giving away big deals and not for them paying off, okay? Especially Dave Dombrowski in Detroit. So don't worry about giving up J.D. Martinez in the free agent market, right? What do you need to do? Bolster your starting rotation. Go in, the same money that you can put on J.D. Martinez, you can put it on Jake Arrieta. You can maybe put it on Yu Darvish, okay? I also don't think J.D. Martinez's personality is going to fit well in Boston. He's a guy that got cut from the Astros about 5 years ago and they were nothing. He went to Detroit and resurrected his career, but he had Miguel Cabrera, Ian Kinsler, Victor Martinez, all these stud perennial MVP all-star guys to hide in front of. If he comes to Boston, Boston media, we know how friendly they are, right? They're going to get after him. And now all of a sudden, if he's the bat that's supposed to be in the lineup every day producing the most, I don't like the expectation on J.D. Martinez in Boston. I like J.D. Martinez in a lot of other places, not in Boston. Go out, get a starter, Boston. Shore up that rotation. Back up Pomerantz. Back up Stephen Wright. Maybe back up Porcello if he has a bad year or something happens, okay? So spend your money wisely, not on J.D. Martinez, but on, if anything, go get Eric Hosmer. At least you know Hosmer can play first. You can put Moreland in the DH role, kind of have a platoon in the DH between Hanley and Moreland, but he's going to be a way better option for me long-term, Eric Hosmer over J.D. Martinez, all right? The kind of small one thing I was to say is I'm also a fan of Brock Holt. Man, this guy can't be underestimated this year in Boston. I don't see a lot of middle utility guys in the prospect list coming up this year for Boston. So Brock Holt can play backup third base, second base, outfield positions, okay? This little scrappy guy, Brock Holt, is going to fill in for second base for Dustin Pedroia. So how good Brock Holt can play will be a big way that Boston can go this year. So keep an eye out for that. Brock Holt will be instrumental in Boston's success this year. And that's it, guys. We're going to be back with tomorrow or the next day. Spencer Dodger doing what he does love best. Here I am mumbling and fumbling, kind of getting the cobwebs out right at this spring training. Not sure if you saw my last video, but had a little dry spot going on. And it made me remember Vin Scully. Vin Scully, my idol, my mentor, always liked to suck on a Jolly Rancher. Green apple, by the way. Between every half inning to keep his saliva going from talking, okay? You keep talking a lot, as I do my videos live, one take. You know, it's a little scratchy. The saliva starts lathering up a little bit. So if you're ever going to do this business, do what Vin Scully did. Fall in love with Jolly Ranchers. I'm on board now. Hopefully, I'm going to do a little bit better. All right, let's sign off. Thank you so much to the Midnite Players for watching, for the baseball gods for making it all happen, my sponsor, racklife.org. If you want to give random acts of kindness into whatever community you live in all over the world, talk to us at racklife.org. We'll listen to your story. We'll listen to how we can make a difference, and hopefully we'll do it together. We'll talk to y'all soon. Woo!